How am I going to cross list? I'm going to watch this video from 5 Minutes of Canvas. I'm Greg Beyer, and I've been teaching with technology since the days of HyperCard. I've spent most of my career with Cosumnes River College and the online network of educators. If you'd like to see more videos on how to use technology to support teaching and learning, please subscribe. In this video, I'm going to show how to cross-list courses in Canvas. This helps instructors by giving us just one place where we have to upload content, post announcements, and otherwise engage with our students. It helps our students because it's less likely that we're going to forget to perhaps post something in one of our Canvas courses. But before I get started, there are a couple of points I want to make about cross-listing. And to do that, I'm going to turn to Camera 2. Hello, Camera 2. There are two important points that I want to make about cross-listing. One is that cross-listing is a user privilege that is a default permission for instructor users in Canvas, but it is possible that individual Canvas-using institutions will either not allow instructors to cross-list, will otherwise control how instructors cross-list, or might even restrict when cross-listing is available based on their academic calendar. Second, keep in mind the Family Educational Rights and Privacy Act. This is a law that is designed to protect the privacy of student records, and under certain interpretations of this law, it may not be permissible for students enrolled in one section of a class to see who else is enrolled in another section of the class. Let's get back to Camera 1. As I mentioned, cross-listing is a tool that can help instructors and students make more efficient use of Canvas. It's demo time. In this example, I'm teaching two sections of History 310, and my college has put the section number as part of the course title. In order to cross-list, I have to decide which of the two sections that I want to keep and go and actually run the cross-listing from the other section. One thing that's important to know about cross-listing is that it removes the users from the course that is being cross-listed, and that includes the instructor. So in this example, I'm going to keep section 12345, and I'm going to go into my section 54321, go to the settings page for this course, and then go to sections, select the section for this course, and then select the button to cross-list this section. Canvas gives us a couple of options to cross-list this. One is we can search for the course, or we can enter the course's ID. In Canvas, the course ID is the number that ends the URL on the course homepage. So going back to my dashboard, the course that I want to keep, I'm going to select that course, copy the number that's at the end of the course URL, and paste this into the cross-list section dialog in the other course. After I paste and hit the tab key, Canvas recognizes the other course, and then I can select the button to cross-list this section. The page that I'm looking at will not change aside from getting the receipts. How I know that this has worked is I can select the button to go back to course settings. And on the sections tab, I'll see that I have two sections now instead of just one. If I go back to my dashboard, the course that I cross-listed from has disappeared. Now that both sections are linked to the same Canvas course, I will also change the course name so that my students are less likely to be confused. To do this, I select the course, go to the settings page, and give the course a name that will make sense to students in both sections. Thank you for watching this video. Please comment in the doobly-doo. Do you think that cross-listing will help your students succeed? Also, I would love to get your suggestions on topics that you would like explained in just 5 minutes. Never stop learning, and I'll see you in the next one.